1, 2, 3, go!
People keep wanting to beat me, and it possibly means they're having to catch me.
There's a lot of pressure on Mike in this event. He really is the one to beat. I can't wait to see what he pulls out on race day.
And here is race day. Mike has lived well with the pressure. And although he didn't play in the scrum, he certainly knows how to push. He's pushing here 280 kilograms, and he pushed well, got in well, very rhythmical. Let's see what the time is for the start. 6.15. Now he's just got to sit there, all 6 foot two of him crammed in. Great line. Absolutely no problems. This is a very, very clean ride. 121.5 kilometers per hour. And he's traveling well, and he finishes well. It looks a good time. So has he lived up to expectation?
Oh, that was fast.
It was not fast at the top, though. It wasn't the fastest.
Well, we'll see. Right, remember, whoever clocks the quickest time is going to stay in the competition. The loser's going to be facing the jump. I know that neither of you two want to face the jump tonight. You both had a horrible time with crashes, etc. So, Mike, let's reveal your time. It is 55.28 nice. Seconds. Happy with that?
Yeah, it's going to be close because JB's got skills.
JB's got skills and you've got attitude. You want to beat this man, don't you?
Of course. Yeah.
Let's see how you did in the bobsleigh.
Thank you. Mike and Louise are definitely the front runners for this event. I'm going to venture to say I'm not that far behind them. JB, absolute surprise package. That was sick. Saw the first push and thought, aye, that's not a pop star. Those legs have got power in them. Turns out he's played a bit of rugby. Played a bit of rugby, semi-professional.
Oh, Tindall. Does he know?
He does, yeah.
Brilliant, a bit of competition.
A lot of the things that I used to do when I was training is going to come into play with the bobsleigh, you know. It's a lot of high explosive speed, high leg drive and power. Come race day, the front runners in this event should definitely forget the underdogs at their peril.
So, have the other competitors underestimated JB Gill? He's looking forward to this. Look at the position of the back foot, if he can get a good push. And by heck, he got a good push, and he's following it by fine sprinting and a really fluent arrival into the bob. This is going to be a good time. 5.95, the sprint time for the start. The record for this Olympic course is 4.96. That's how good that was. And he's continuing on in great style here. He's going to have a fast speed at the fastest point of the course, 120.5. Still going strong. It's a very, very good run by JB Gill.
Oh, JB, honestly, that was a great run. And you guys choosing each other, so mad, because one of you was quickest and one of you was second quickest. So it is the moment of truth. Whoever clocks the quickest time stays in the competition. So, Mike, you raced first. We know you got a time of 55.28 seconds. JB, have you beaten that? Let's find out. You did beat that. That's got to feel good, hasn't it?
It does feel good. Mike was a worthy opponent, so cheers,
really
Mike.
Was. And such bad luck for you getting pulled with JB because you got the second fastest time.
Yeah, it happens, doesn't it? Doesn't matter.
OK, give it up for Mike and JB, everyone. Good luck, Mike.
Good job, Mike.
Little bit slow with the push. And a bit of a hit, well, a little awkwardly, but he made it. The split time will tell us how good that start.